According to data from the Ministry of Health, more than 90,000 Ugandans fall ill of TB every year, and 30 people die every day. Last year alone, 96,000 people were diagnosed with the infection. While the infection has treatment, identification of cases and treatment remains an overwhelming challenge as health service providers deal with the stigma associated with the disease due to limited awareness of the disease.
The barriers of TB treatment cut across. One of the first things I would talk about is so many things affect patients, especially coming for treatment. One is that some don't even know what TB is. Some do not know information. They have limited knowledge about TB. They will have symptoms for a while and they will be sick. They come in when they are sick for over 8 months and they have visited all other alternative sources of medicines and other health centers until they are not fine anymore. Then they will think about tuberculosis. So I would say there is a knowledge gap in us, the community.
TB is caused by the bacterium Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which most commonly affects the lungs. Transmitted through the air and when a person with TB coughs, sneezes or talks near you. It causes coughing, fever, night sweats, chest pains, weight loss, symptoms that can remain mild for several months. An infected person may not feel the need to quickly consult a doctor, increasing transmission of the disease to others. The TB bacterium is airborne. It can be transmitted by coughing, sneezing, or spitting. It is estimated that every untreated TB patient transmits the disease to 15 other people in a year. But only 5 to 10% of these people actually develop the active disease. Typically, people with a weakened immune system, such as those with HIV and diabetes.
So TB is always attached to HIV. The other misconception everyone has is that only HIV patients get tuberculosis. However, everyone is at risk of having tuberculosis. HIV just increases your risk of having tuberculosis.
With treatment, TB can be cured. Patients must take 4 anti-tuberculosis drugs over a period of 6 months. However, Dr. Jambo says that this too comes with challenges like drug resistance.
Drug-resistant TB is when the TB germ continues to grow, even in presence of those first-line drugs. It will still continue to grow. That means that the drugs are not working on that TB germ. So that means we have to now go to a second line of defense, which we call the second-line drugs. Okay? So that one, they can be for 9 months, they can be for 11 months, and they can be for 18 months. There is guidance according to our national program, who is able to receive which length of treatment.
Although Uganda is steadily striving to achieve its goal in the fight against TB, the road ahead is still dotted with challenges. It is therefore against this background that the Ministry of Health, in partnership with Uganda Cares, Uganda Stop Tuberculosis and the AIDS Support Organization, have organized a TB marathon to create the much-needed awareness on Sunday. The Assistant Commissioner at the National Tuberculosis and Leprosy Division of the Ministry of Health, Dr. Stevia Chuliahabwe, said the marathon comes ahead of the National Awareness Campaign on CAST TB. The funds collected will go towards construction of an isolation unit at Iganga Hospital.